In this video, I'm going to tell you about a brief introduction to my helmet, which blinks when it brakes or accelerates. Let's take a look at the board first. Here's your board. Here's truck and wheels. This board has one VESC, which has two channels. I will draw a box here. And this is VESC, the motor driver, VESC. This VESC is connected with your wheels, motors exactly. Here's three lines for each motors. So it has six lines to there. This is motor line. Of course, it has power line, which is from battery. There must be plus and minus line here. To move this skateboard, we need a remote controller. Here's remote controller. And it has its own battery here, but we don't need to know about this at all. And it has transceiver, radio transceiver. And here on the VESC side, let's think about this box is inside of a skateboard world. And let's say this yellow box is remote controller world. We need to send a signal from remote controller to skateboard world signal. But it's not wired, it's wireless. So let's draw like this. It's wireless. That means inside of a skateboard world, there must be a receiver. Here's receiver. By the way, 1 year ago, I used VX1 remote controller from FlipSky. And this receiver is also VX1 receiver. This receiver is connected with VESC with wire. Actually, it has several wires. We can choose either PPM signal or UART signal. PPM is the classical way of giving or receiving the remote signal. This is a common way of RC world. So basically, this receiver need power, 5 volt, and ground, and PPM signal output, or UART signal input and output. We call it TX and RX. So when I used VX1 receiver, I could choose PPM or UART. Last time I made a LED for skateboard, I installed an Arduino with Neopixel LED and connected one line to PPM. And also, I use UART to get a remote signal and transmit the motor controller's status. But at this moment, I am using VESCtool remote controller from FlipSky. It has LCD screen. You can see the speed, battery status, tachometer, current, and many information. But the problem is VX2 remote controller is not compatible with VX1. VX2 transceiver only available with VX2 receiver. And VX2 receiver doesn't give any PPM signal. It only gives UART signal. It means I cannot use this Arduino, this LED, and this. But luckily, there's another way of getting motor controller's status. By the way, we have to know current status of VESC in order to light LED based on the speed or brake, etc. Luckily, I used two channel VESC, so here's channel 1 UART and here's channel 2 UART. I decided to use channel 2 to get VESC status. So I installed another board. Here's HC12. This board is also need 5 volt or 3.3 volt and minus. And then here's TX and RX. There's also TX and RX from channel 2 VESC UART. I need to connect the pin TX to RX, pin RX to pin TX. The reason why I installed HC12 is getting the information and status from VESC to outside of this skateboard world. Because I cannot connect wire or cable from skateboard to helmet at all. That's ridiculous. I need to make it remote. So here's my helmet. Let's draw a box to show the helmet world. Here's helmet world. In the helmet world, I need LED and a microcontroller to control LED. I used Adafruit Feather M0 BLE. It has BLE integrated. So I installed another HC12. I gave 3.3 volt as a power and ground here. And here's TX and RX. And Feather board has also TX RX. I connected TX from HC12 to RX of Feather and RX to TX. In this way, you can communicate VESC with Feather. They are communicate each other and they carry a signal. Of course, we need to configure HC12 here and here by using USB to UART interface board. And we need to set the baud rate, let's say the speed setting as 15200. In this way, I can read the status of VESC anytime and send any signal to VESC. So finally, I can read RPM, current, etc. And based on that information, I can turn LED as I wanted. One more thing I did was that here's our phone world. I'm using an Android phone and I am using VESCtool. VESCtool is very powerful for those who use VESC driver. With the VESCtool, you can check all the current status of the VESC and you can also set a VESC configuration. And this VESCtool and this Android phone is communicating with BLE. That's why I bought and I am using Feather M0 BLE. So they are communicate with BLE wireless. If I want to read skateboard information or configuration, I simply turn on VESCtool and set anything through this communication path. Also, this Feather M0 BLE board request information and receive that information and process and then turn on LED based on that information. It's also remote controller independent. We don't need to worry about PPM anymore and physical connection from remote receiver. I somehow worried about physical attachment from receiver to Arduino, because this Arduino takes a large amount of current when the LED turns on. And if something was wrong with this 5-volt line, which is shared with Arduino, that must be disaster, because the only one way to stop the skateboard is using remote controller. There's one more thing I need to explain, is that the battery. I used 200 milliampere hour lithium polymer battery pack and connected this with this feather board. But I put plus line here and here with a switch, a power switch, so I can turn on and off from outside of this frame. Of course, I attached minus line here with a feather. The feather board has lithium polymer charging circuit, so we don't need to worry about charging. You can simply charge the lithium polymer battery with USB cable. One thing you need to care about is this lithium polymer battery should have a PCM circuit, which protect your battery when it goes too low voltage or too high voltage. To check whether your battery has PCM or not, here's the way. Battery pack looks like this. And there's some another layer or another part apart from this battery body. And here's cable. And you will see if there's a PCM circuit with battery, there's small component on here was covered by some tape. Then it has PCM. Lastly, I built some code and programmed feather board and printed the cover by my 3D printer.